WRCA-TV New York, Channel 4.
Say When is presented by the NBC Television Network. Here's the host of Say When, Art James.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And thank you, Ron Howell, and welcome everyone to Say When, Television Game Show, and I'm sure it's going to be one of the most exciting. And what can I say, you know, from the standpoint of being very anxious for you to like the show and so forth, I think the thing that makes me happiest about this premiere performance of Say When is to be in a studio filled with relatives. And sometimes we better get the show off the ground. So without further ado, let's play Say When by meeting our first two contestants. And they are, may I have your card, please? How do you do? This is Miss Mary Guest from Stamford, Connecticut. Mrs. Mary Guest, I'm sorry. And from Brooklyn, New York, Mr. Paul Mortensen. Welcome to both of you. Well, Mary, just in the way of a 30-second conversation, I see you've been married 5.5 years.
That's right.
You have 4 children.
That's right.
And 1 on the way.
That's right.
Will it be triplets on the way?
I hope not.
That's wonderful. That's the one so young.
Thank
you.
You've
been married at 7 years old or something like that.
A little older.
Yes, you're very lovely.
Thank you
for coming. Mr. Mortensen, well, here's the thing. He's a deckhand on a tugboat, and you fly the waters in and around Manhattan. Is that right?
That's right. Brooklyn, Manhattan, the Bronx, and Staten Island, too.
Right. what goes with the tugboat thing? Is this the maneuvering liners into port, or you're towing things along?
That's right. Well, we're putting in the big liners and doing all these barge work to keep the harbor going all the time.
Good. Well, good luck to you, Paul.
Yeah,
and let's get right into the game, shall we? Here's how to play Say When. Now, you're going to pick whatever prizes you want from our game board. Every time you pick, we'll tell you what the prize is worth and add the number of dollars to your score. Now, your goal for this game is $750. Don't forget to say when you've had enough. The one closest to $750, without busting over, wins the game and keeps all the prizes he's gotten during the game, and also is entitled to meet the winner of the next $750 game in a championship match worth $2,000. Okay? Okay. Let's start by reviewing the first 4 prizes we have for you. Look up at the game board and listen to this information. In the number one position is a tape recorder. It's a dual-speed, high-fidelity portable by Wolintech. Number 2 is a sewing machine. The Riviera console model by Brother International with an imported hand-polished cabinet. Number 3, luggage. A lightweight 6-piece set covered in vinyl for the man and woman by Samsonite. And number 4, a pair of table lamps. They're in traditional design by Rembrandt with antique gold shades and satin gold bases. Now, I'd like to point out to both of you that no one prize in this game is worth more than $750. Okay? Shall we be off? They're looking at the prizes. Their eyes are agleam. And Mrs. Guest, pick a prize and we're off and running.
I'll pick number 1, please.
Well, you've mentioned the number now. Let me say to both of you, pick according to the prize itself, and I think it'll be a lot clearer if you go on.
The stereo.
The stereo. Or you mean the tape recorder.
Tape recorder.
Okay. We go and find that the tape recorder is actually worth $200. That's a very good start. Now, on to you, Mr. Mortensen. It's a fairly open spot on the board. You see, we have a vacant spot here. We need a new prize. It's a matter of chance. And you fill it by collecting one of these numbers.
I'll choose number 8, Art.
Number 8. All right. And we'll tell you what number 8 is. As our machine clanks furiously in the background, and we see an air purifier. It's portable, requires no installation, and is by Curitron. Now, you've got 4 to choose from. Pick anyone you want.
I'll choose the luggage.
He's taking the luggage, all right. And the luggage is worth... It's $178. All right, so very close, running neck and neck as we go on, and have you, Mrs. Guest, put a prize on the board.
Number 10.
You think that will be lucky for you. We'll see if it is. Number 10 happens to be a blank check. Now, fill in the amount you want. It's for canned hams, Mrs. Guest. The 4-pound size by Hafnia. You may have from 1 to 100 cans. You must take at least 1. You can have up to 100 cans. How many do you want? You've got $200. You're on your way to $750. Now, at this point, let me remind both of you, and figure out these mathematics in your mind as I explain this, that if you think one more prize will take you as close to $750 as you care to go, you must Say when by announcing in advance that it is your last pick. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Keep that in mind, Mrs. Guest. You may have from 1 to 110. 4-pound size. How many do you
have? I'm going to pick 100.
100?
Yes.
Will this be your last pick?
When.
She is saying when with 100 canned hams. $200 plus 100 hams for Mrs. Guest. Now, on to you, Mr. Mortensen. Put a prize on the board.
Number 12.
Number 12, right at the bottom here. And we'll see what number 12 has in store for you. It happens to be a cupboard. It's the High Sink Lebanon model by Miracle Americana, made of selected pine. Any one of the four, Mr. Mortensen?
I'll choose the Americana.
All right. You realize you have $178 going for $750. It's not your last pick.
No, that's right.
Okay. He's taking the cupboard. And we find that the value of the cupboard is $270, the total now for Mr. Mortensen, of $448. Mr. Guest has made your last pick. You've still got the ball, Mr. Mortensen, so put another prize
on
the board.
I'll take number six.
Number six this time. This time, it is a radio, an 8-transistor portable with its own carrying case by Channel Master. There it is. You can take any one of the four, Mr. Mortensen. You've got $448. Say when you've had enough.
I'll take the Channel Master.
It's not your last pick.
No, sir.
And he's taking the transistor portable radio. Let's find out the value of it. It happens to be $60. A total now for Mr. Mortensen of $508. It's still your turn, Mr. Mortensen. Put a prize in the board.
I'll take number five.
Number five this time. All right. We'll see what five brings for you. Oh, a blank check. Fill in the odds you want. He's happy about it. It's for perfume. Lemon by Coty. Mr. Mortensen, you may have from 120 bottles. In each bottle, there are 1.86 ounces. So take it over carefully. Save when you've had enough. You've got $508. You're going for
$750. I'll take seven bottles.
You're taking seven
and
bottles.
Say when.
You're saying when,
yes,
with seven bottles of Lemon by Coty. $508 plus perfume for Mr. Mortensen. Let's go to Mrs. Guest's side of the board. Here she is with $200 plus 100 canned hams. This is the moment. All set? Yes, she is set. We'll find out that the value of the hams actually are $400, a grand total for Mrs. Guest, $600. All right, now over to you, Mr. Mortensen. You got $508 plus the perfume. Let's find out what the perfume is worth. I think our machine is broke. No.
Oh, good.
The value of the perfume is $210, a grand total for Mr. Mortensen, $718 for the value of Mr. Mortensen. I express our gratitude at having played a game very well, Mrs. Guest, and we have a going-away gift for you. Let's go to Wayne Howell and find out what it is.
For your going-away gift, Mrs. Guest, we have a Polaroid Land Camera Model 95B, which now makes sparkling pictures in just 10 seconds. And thanks for being with us on Say When.
Well, in our foremost congratulations to you, Paul Mortensen, let's find out exactly what this was.
Well, you have won a 6-piece set of lightweight jet-age luggage by Samsonite, covered in sturdy vinyl, creating a smart, stylish exterior. Included are two cases for the man and four for the traveling needs of a lady. Plus, a beautiful high-sink cupboard of solid selected pine with hand-rubbed and hand-finished panel doors. There's plenty of serving space in this early American design by Miracle Americana. Plus, a dual-purpose 8-transistor portable radio by Channel Master. Its high-impact case has a built-in extension antenna for bringing in distant stations. And for your own personal use, there's a magnetic earphone. Plus, seven bottles of Lemont perfume by Coty. Nothing makes a woman more feminine than Lemont by Coty. And all of this is brought to you with the compliments of Say When.
Well, Mr. Mortensen, you think the captain of the tugboat will enjoy some of that perfume that you're going to give to him?
I don't know. I don't think he goes for that aftershave.
Well, maybe you know somebody on the garbage show that will get by anyway. Mr. Mortensen, we're going to send you to the winner's chair to watch our next game. The winner will be your opponent in the $2,000 championship match. Mr. Mortensen, our seat of honor, the winner's chair, and we'll be back to you in a few moments.
Thank you.
Good. We'll meet the contestants who will play in the second $750 game in just a moment, but right now, there's something very interesting for you to stop, look, and listen to. Watch this. Welcome back to Say When to our second $750 game. And let's do that by meeting our two new contestants. They are Mr. Ed Hobby from Elizabeth, New Jersey, and from Cowdery, Colorado, Mrs. Marion Frick. Well, Ed, the only information I have for you is very skimpy, but very mysterious and intriguing. You are a securities analyst and a bachelor.
Right.
Have you weighed the risk between the two and chosen the security analyst thing? Or?
Well, until tonight, I've never had the courage to say when.
I see. And there's something very interesting as far as your bias is concerned, Mrs. Frick. Cowdery, if I pronounce that correct, Colorado?
That's correct.
I take it it's a small town?
Very small, about 25 people.
I see. And your husband is a wrestler.
Oh, a rancher.
No, it's a rancher. I'm sorry. Colorado, someplace I've never been to, and it's something I'm sure I'd be awed at the grandeur of it. I'd love to go there sometime.
I'm sure you'd enjoy it.
Well, if I go, Cowdery will be 26 people. But anyway, we'll play pretty well. I think you're both familiar with rules now, so let's get right into it by revealing the first four prizes we have for you. They're going to appear on the game board. Watch them closely and listen to the information. In the number one position is a slide projector. It's a fully automatic model by Revere. Number two is a range. It's an electric model by Tappan with a 17-inch oven. Number three is a clock, the Gloucester Banjo model by Sessions. Gloucester is the correct pronunciation. And number four is pottery, a service for eight by Falstaff, totaling 45 pieces. There are the first four. No one prize in this game is worth more than $750, and that's your goal, $750. But by now you're familiar with the blank check. The value of the blank check prize could put you over $750, depending on how much of it you took. So keep that in mind, and we'll begin with you, Mr. Hobby. Pick a prize. And we're off and running with Save Win.
The slide projector on.
All right, taking the slide projector, and let's find out the value of it is. The slide projector is worth $155. Very good. Mrs. Frick, it's up to you to put a prize on the board.
Number seven.
She's taking lucky seven, or at least we hope it's lucky for you. And number seven happens to be a blank check right off the bat. All right, fill in the amount, Mrs. Frick. It's for ladies' blouses, something you may be familiar with, in colorful, carefree fabric. By Ship and Shore, you may have from 1 to 100 blouses. At least one, but up to 100.
50 blouses.
50 blouses. Let's find out what they're worth. 50 blouses. The value is $200. Very good. Back to you, Mr. Hobby, and you must put a prize on the board.
Number 11.
Number 11. 7 and 11 by two different people. All right. We have for you, to replace the vacant spot, a vacuum cleaner, Mr. Hobby. A aerosol canister cleaner with fingertip suction control and mobile platforms by Westinghouse. So you can take any one of the four. You've got $155. Well, he has picked a clock, and in a moment we'll find out the value of that clock. But that chime means that right now we must allow the local stations to identify themselves. So stay with us. We'll be back in just a moment.
Welcome back to the second half of Say When. And once again, here's your host, Art James.
And thank you again, Len Howell. Welcome back to Say When. We're in the midst of a game between Mrs. Marion Frick and Mr. Ed Hobby. The winner of this game, don't forget, will meet the winner of the first $750 game. There he is, smiling genially, a man of power, Mr. Mortensen. All right, now when we left off, we have totals of $165 for you, Mr. Hobby, $200 for you, Mrs. Frick. But it was Mr. Hobby's turn, and he had actually selected a prize, which we want to find the value of right now. You had selected the clock, is that right, Mr. Hobby? You have $155, let's find out what the clock is worth. $30, a total now for Mr. Hobby, $185. Up to you, Mrs. Frick, to put a prize on the board.
Number 10.
She's taking number 10, and we'll see what number 10 includes. Have you already had a blank check? You've got another one. Fill in the amount you want. It's for orchid plants this time. They are Hawaiian hybrids from Orchids of Hawaii Incorporated. You may have from 1 to 20 orchid plants. You've got $200. Say when you've had enough. 1 to 20 plants. How much?
3 plants.
She's taking 3 orchid plants. All right. Let's find out the value of the orchid. 3 plants are worth $75. The total now for Mrs. Frick. $275. Back to you, Mr. Hobby. Put a prize on the board.
Number 8.
Number 8. Okay. Number eight happens to be a blank check for Dad's Root Beer.
That's what I need.
All right, Mr. Harvey. Now, don't be greedy, but you can have from 1 to 250 cases. And there are 6 half-gallon bottles per case. 6 half-gallon bottles per case. You've got to take at least one case, but you can take up to 250.
I'll take 5 cases.
It's not your last case. I'm only reminding you.
Oh, right.
You have $185.
I'll still take 5 cases.
All right, it's not as much. Okay, 5 cases of Dad's Root Beer are worth $15. All right, the total now for Mr. Hobby, $200. Cautiously and quietly, he builds to 750, and it's Mr. Sixth turn to put a prize on the board.
Number 12.
Number 12, right at the bottom. I withdraw the card, and our machine manufactures a picture back there. And here it comes, a pair of candelabras in sterling silver. From Michael C. Keenan. You've got 4 to choose from. Any one of the 4 you want, Mr. Strick. You have $275. You're going for $750. I think it's still when you've had enough.
I'll pick 2 and say when.
She's saying when, and her last pick is, what was the prize?
2, the stove.
Yeah, that's it. Pick by the prize itself. She's saying when with the stove. All right. The range goes up on Mrs. Strick's score with $275. We're not going to reveal the value of the range for you right now, Mrs. Strick, as we outweigh the outcome on the last pick by Mr. Hobby. Mr. Hobby,
number 9.
Think carefully, put a prize on the board, and he's picking number 9. All right, number 9. There it is, a snow remover. It's the Snowbird Power Model by George Garden Tools. You've got 4 to choose from. You've got $200. You're going for $750.
I'll take the vacuum cleaner.
Right, and you're keeping in mind when to say when. All right, he's taking the vacuum cleaner. Let's find out what the vacuum cleaner's worth. $60. That gives Mr. Hobby now a total of $260. And it's still your turn for a prize on the board.
Number 6.
Number 6. All right. He's amassing many prizes slowly. And there's bedding. 2 twin-size mattresses and springs by Jameson Bedding Incorporated. Still got your pick from any one of the 4.
I'll say when and take number 2.
He's saying when, and he's taking which one? What is
number
the prize?
The snow remover.
The snow remover plus $260. Now that's on Mr. Hobby's side of the board. Okay, Mrs. Cook, are you anxious to find out what your total is? This is the moment of decision, so let's do it. In your own mind, what did you think the range was worth?
About
$400. That would give you a good score, close to $750. You've got $275 plus the range. Let's find out what the range is actually worth. $455 for Mrs. Strick, a grand total of $730. Hang on, though, because there's a lot of strength involved here because you're up against a good player who has got 4 or 5 prizes on his side of the board. $260 was the important one, the snow plow. Here we go, Mr. Hobby. The snowplow is actually worth $230, a grand total for Mr. Hobby. $490, the winner of this game is Mrs. Marion Strick. Don't be such a hero, sir, right off, Ed, because we do want to commend you for offering a very exciting game, and we have a going-away gift for you, too. Wayne?
For your going-away gift, Mr. Trick, we have a Polaroid Land Camera Model 95B, which now takes sparkling pictures in just 10 seconds. And thanks for being with us on Say When.
Well, that means you're entitled to meet Mr. Mortensen in our championship match with $2,000, which we'll get into in just a moment. But first of all, let's recount your prizes, shall we? Congratulations, Mary and Trick. Let's find out exactly what you've won.
Well, you've won 50 lovely new blouses by Ship and Shore. They're perfect for both day and night and the carefree fabric women love. Plus, 3 orchid plants, the new exotic hybrids that have been developed in Hawaii, the newest and one of the most glamorous states in the Union. Plus, an electric range by Tappan with these gold-ribbon features. Adjust the height broiler, chrome-lined 17-inch oven, and a divided 4-unit cooking top. All with the compliments of Say When.
All right, Marion Trick, in a moment, you will meet the winner of our previous game, Paul Mortensen, in a championship match worth $2,000. So think about that, and we'll play the championship match in just a moment. But first, Here is a message for you from NBC. Watch carefully. Here we go. Championship match for $2,000. Marion Trick and Paul Mortensen. You've each won a $750 game and therefore have earned the right to compete with one another in our championship match, the goal of which is $2,000. What is that aroma? I think it's Lehmann's perfume. You've got seven bottles of it from the previous day. All right, now let's review the prizes we have for you, and they're good ones. So listen carefully as we get into our championship match, and here come the prizes. In the number one position is an automobile, the newest 850 two-door sedan. It's equipped with heater, full leather seating, and white wall tires. Number two, a television and hi-fi. It's the Woodbridge Home Entertainment Unit by RCA, featuring a 23-inch television screen and a six-speaker stereo hi-fi sound system. Number three, a man's watch, a 30-jewel fully automatic waterproof by Helbro, with a chrome top case and a stainless steel back. And number four, a refrigerated bar, the modern lowboy. Mr. Morganson, you're smiling. It's by Springer Penguin Incorporated. It has a 2-cubic-foot refrigerator and a dry storage compartment for glasses and bottles. All right, now, since Marion Trick was closest to $750 in her game, actually said $730, Marion, that gives you the privilege to pick the first prize. Pick a prize, and here we go in our championship match.
I'll pick the car, Hart.
Oh, she's taking the car. She wants it, and you've got it. And let's take a look at the value of the car, which is $1,405. Ingenious strategy, because she doesn't seem unnerved by it at all. Mr. Mortensen, it's your turn to put a prize on the board.
I'll take number 10, Arthur.
All right, number 10. And let's see what number 10 is. Mr. Mortensen, it is a camera. It's an electric iMatic still camera by Revere. Any one of the four, we're going for $2,000.
I'll take the television set.
He's taking the TV and hi-fi, and we find out the value of it is $750. Back to you, Mrs. Strick. Put a prize on the board.
Number seven, please.
Number seven. All right, let's see what that is. Number seven is a fur coat. A Southwest African Persian lamb coat with a tourmaline mink collar by Schiaparelli. Now, I must point out to you that you got $1,405. You must say when you've had enough. Keep that in mind. Take any one of these four prizes.
I'll take the refrigerated bar.
Will it be your last pick, Mrs. Trick?
No.
It will not be her last pick, and she's taking the refrigerated bar. Okay, let's find out what the bar is worth. Its value of it is $430. Well, Mrs. Trick now has a total of $1,835. If you go to you, Mr. Mortensen, put a prize on the board.
I'll go to number 12, Bob.
Number 12, right at the bottom. Let's hope it's lucky for you, Mr. Mortensen. Number 12 is a piano. It's an early American console piano by Story and Clark, standing 40 inches high and with a maple finish. Any one of the four, you've got $750. You're going for $2,000.
I'll go for the Schiaparelli fur coat.
Will it be? Are you saying when or not?
Let me see now. Can I have another
discussion? I just wanted to remind you of it.
No, I will say when, no.
It's not say when, and you're taking the fur coat.
Yes.
All right, let's find out the value of the fur coat. It is $1,250, a total now for Mr. Mortensen, $2,000. $2,000 is, I don't even know where to go from here. Well, first of all, we have to go to Mrs. Strick and have her put a prize on the board. Mrs. Strick?
Number 11.
Number 11. All right, number 11, Mrs. Trick, you may like this because it's a blank check. You can fill in the amounts you want. They are for dresses in a wide assortment of fabrics and colors by Sue Brett. You may have from 1 to 50 dresses. You must take at least one. How many do you want? You've got $1,835. That's going to $2,000. Dresses by Sue Brett, 1 to 50.
5 dresses.
Are you saying when?
Say when.
This is her last pick, and she's taking 5 dresses. $1,835 plus the dresses for Mrs. Strick. And to go to you, Mr. Mortensen.
I have to go.
You didn't say when, so you must put a prize on the board.
I'll
Choose number five out, please.
Number five. All right, let's see what number five is. It's the massage lounge chair. It's by Niagara and has three cyclomassage motors concealed deep in foam rubber. All right.
I'll choose the dresses.
Well, it'll be more or less more. She's taking the dresses, and the dresses, I think, your last pick is almost a formality.
One dress.
Go through this. No, you can't. No, the dresses aren't there, Mr. Mortensen, so you must take one of the four we have, which are the lounge chair, the camera, the man's watch, and the piano.
I'll put the watch out.
All right, he's taking the watch, and it will be your last pick, I assume.
Yes.
$2,000 plus the watch for Mr. Mortensen, and we may as well reveal the value of the watch, which is $85. Mr. Mortensen has gone over to $2,085. But don't despair, Mr. Mortensen, because everything hangs in the balance, because Mrs. Frick has to have her score revealed. $1,835 plus the value of the dresses, which are... Here they come. I think they're coming. $125 a grand total for Mrs. Frick. $1,960 for the champion is Mrs. Frick. Well, you see, Mr. Mortensen, there was an element of suspense there because she could have gone over to him, but she played very well. And you don't have to feel too bad because all the prizes you won in the $750 game are yours to keep forever. So enjoy them with our best wishes. And now to you, Mrs. Marion Trick, may we find out exactly what you've won.
A new Morris 850 two-door sedan with heater, foam rubber seating, and white wall tires. The seat more comfortably, travels 40 miles to the gallon, and has a top speed of 75 miles per hour. Plus, a handsome refrigerated bar, the Little Boy model by Springer Penguin Incorporated, in a veneer wood finish with a formica serving top of matching wood grain. It has plenty of dry storage space and a 2-cubic-foot refrigerator. Plus, 5 dresses from Sue Brett Incorporated, an assortment of sheaves, linens, cottons, and silk shirtwaists, all in a variety of colors and designs. And congratulations from Say When.
Yay!
Congratulations. You've both been very exciting, colorful contestants. You've added a lot to the game. Congratulations, and thank you very much for playing Say When.
Thank you.
Well, that's all the time we have for today, but we certainly enjoyed having you with us, and we hope you'll be able to join us next time when we play Say When. So until then, this is our James wishing you a very happy day, and so long. Don't forget to say when.
Say When was presented by the NBC Television Network. Say When is a Mark Goodson, Bill Cotton production. In association with the NBC Television Network.
Daytime, nighttime, to get the right time, call Meridian 7-1212.